Enduring truth number two, North Korea meets pressure with pressure of their own. You hit them, they hit you back. We hit them, it doesn't work. They hit us back. What is the answer? Pressure didn't work. What should we do? More pressure. They match us. And at some point, we say, are we going to start a war? You know, sanctions, more threats. Are we going to start a war? When we get up there, we go back to point number one. Deterrence works. No, we're not. And so we do the cycle all over again. We find some way to back down, and then something happens, and pretty soon, more pressure. It didn't work. More pressure will work. They are not going to back down with more pressure. That is, there's overwhelming evidence that they don't. So I'm going to give you three examples of that. The first one is this. You probably don't know this. Do you guys know the sinking of the Chunan ship in 2010? Many of you do know. North Korea sank a South Korean corvette, a South Korean naval ship with a torpedo. Right? What we don't know, in November 2009, South Korea shot up a North Korean ship, engulfing it in flames. We don't know how many North Koreans died. You know why? We don't care. But North Korea said, you will pay a dear price. Do you know what happened? 4 months later, we did. I am not defending it, but it is predictable. They said they were going to do it. And a lot of my friends, my colleagues were like, oh, it's a surprise attack. I said, no, it's not. They said they were going to do it. It is a fist for a fist, a punch for a punch. When they said this is the start of World War III or the Second Korean War, whatever else, I said, no, it's not. They are meeting pressure with pressure of their own. It's not anything more. Sure enough, I was right. It wasn't the start of the Second Korean War, right? Yeonpyeong shelling. South Korea decided to do live ammunition fire exercises with the naked eye of the North Korean shoreline. And the North Koreans say, don't do that. And South Korea said, what are you going to do about it? And North Korea shelled them, and people died. Was that the start of the Second Korean War? No. Once we were done with that, it calmed down. They meet pressure with pressure of their own. It's actually very, very obvious. Number two, right? The second example, this is a B-2 stealth bomber that we run exercises right across the Korean Peninsula. Now, one of the things you should know, it's a stealth bomber. You're not supposed to be able to see it. But what do? We send it across and we go, hey, look, North Korea, look what we're doing. That's muscle flexing. We show them, you know what, we can hit you. Do you know what North Korea does? Oh, yeah, we can hit you back. The point of the missile test is this, and we often miss the point. They are tests. They haven't attacked us yet. They haven't attacked Japan. These are tests. They're showing us, and when they fly them over Japan into the ocean, they're showing we could. If we'd wanted, we could aim it the other way. We could take out Guam. That is muscle flexing. We flex muscles. Do they start running for the hills? No, they say, okay, you want to bring it on? We have spent 64 years preparing to fight the United States. Bring it on. They meet pressure with pressure of their own. Most recently, it might be a little more flamboyant, the kind of talk that is going on these days, from our side and from their side. But fundamentally, the rhetoric that you are hearing over the last year or so is fundamentally the same that we have always said about North Korea. Again, it might be a little more flamboyant, but fundamentally what you've seen over the last year or so has been the same kind of thing, which is deterrence signaling from both sides. And what we always miss on North Korea, this is something where every chance I get when I do media, I point out, we take the mainstream media takes the second half of a clause, which is, comma, we will attack America. And they go, oh my God, the North Koreans said they're going to attack. And we always miss the comma, the first part of the clause, which is, if you attack us first, comma, we will hit you back. That's what they say all the time, right? So what's going on today, right? So here's Trump, our good friend, right? Fire and fury the likes the world has never seen. August 8th. Did North Korea back down? Does anybody know what North Korea did? North Korea said, we might have to hit Guam. Right. 2 days later, they said, you know what? Are we backing down? No, we're going to hit Guam. Trump says today, or last week, Nikki Haley said, we're going to attack you. We might have to annihilate North Korea. You've heard these things over the last couple weeks, right? This literally says, Korea's answer, right? Right? And down there you can see Jeje, which means sanctions, preemptive war, right? This is their answer. Okay, you know what? We can threaten you as much as you threaten us. They're not backing down. They meet pressure with pressure of their own. That's what North Korea does. They aren't unpredictable. They are so predictable. They are the most predictable country in the world. They meet pressure with pressure of their own. We threaten them, they threaten us back. You hit them, they hit you back. And every American president, every South Korean president, when they ask, should we actually attack North Korea, has to answer one question. Will they fight back? Every American president so far, and South Korean president, has answered that question, yes, they will. Everything they're doing is designed to show they will fight back. And they do. Chun-an, Yun-pyeong. Which is why deterrence holds. North Korea is incredibly predictable.